you live.
Hey, did you see that isolated storm this evening in the southeastern sky? Yeah, it's pretty picturesque. This person sent this picture in of it from Lafayette. The handle was Flops Angel, but they didn't give their name. You can see the storm bubbling up right here and hitting the top of what we call the tropopause in our lower atmosphere. It's a warm, dry layer. Storm hits the top of that and fans out. We call that the storm's anvil. And that storm was actually down east of Indianapolis. If we could go to precision right now, you can kind of tell where that storm was. Way down here, we had a storm pop near Beech Grove and move through Greenfield, Indiana. And that's what you were seeing. If you're here in Lafayette looking southeast toward Kokomo, Frankfort, you can see that towering storm as that storm popped through the cap and was able to make it through and produce a brief little downpour just east of Indy. Big upper ridge, it's a dome of hot, dry air. It's warm aloft. It's warm at the surface. It's hard to get much to form storm-wise. You can see all the rainfall kind of moving around it. It's the ring of fire pattern. The big dome is here, and all the showers and storms are kind of working up and around it. But eventually, the ridge will start to break down a little bit, flatten out, and there's a cold front about right here that'll start to slide in, and that will bring at least a few storms of the area Wednesday, and with it being so boiling hot, we may manage at least an isolated severe storm mixed in all that on Wednesday as well. We'll talk more about that here in just a second. But in the meantime, just the hot weather rolls on. 100s again. We'll have several locations tomorrow hit 100 degrees, if not just a hair more, and perhaps 100 again next week. But at least we have some scattered storms Wednesday, Thursday. Hit or miss. That's the thing, about 30 to 40% coverage, and the above normal temperatures and below normal rainfall will roll on through July and right into August. Tonight, steamy, 70 to 73 for the low, 72 Lafayette, 71 Monticello, 71 Frankfort, and 72 at Pine Village and Kentland. Tomorrow, 99 to about 102, 100 Lafayette, 99 Fowler Remington, 99 Frankfort, 102 Rochester, about 100 in Attica, and 99 at Vetersburg with mostly sunny skies. The heat index kept in check because the humidity will be pretty low. Humidity starts to pool and come up a little bit Wednesday. Weak cold front will start to slide in from the northwest. So by afternoon, we'll see some scattered storms forming in the area. And these will gradually start to pull southeastward with highs of 95 to 100. Heat index 100 to 105. And because it's so boiling hot and we can get some really strong updrafts with those storms, what goes up must come down. I wouldn't rule out an isolated microburst, big burst of wind coming out of a storm or two on Wednesday afternoon. Even Thursday, with the front sliding through, still a few widely scattered showers and storms around with 90, but then the front kind of dissipates and that strong heating, that big upper ridge will start to re-expand. So it will cap everything, it will start to heat up. As a matter of fact, we'll be up to 96 Sunday, 100 on Monday, and even though there'll be a lot of storms northeast of here, it's still going to be 100 Tuesday, 98 Wednesday. Notice where all the storms are? Off to our northeast. 7-day forecast, we've got 2 days of scattered storms, which is better than nothing, though. 98 Wednesday, 90 Thursday, and then back to 100 on Monday. This persistent heat has been around, Dan, really since March. It's pretty much the same weather pattern. Shows no signs of really breaking down in a big way anytime soon.
Well, we